You got countries against countries, man. Now tell me that's not going on. Tell me these things is not going on today. And these are signs that Christ spoke about, that you should be watchful of. See?
And there shall be famine, and pestilence, and earthquake in diverse places.
There shall be famine, pestilence, and earthquakes in diverse places. Now tell me, aren't these things happening today? Aren't these things going on today, man? Ask yourself that question, man. These things are occurring every single day. These are the things that Christ spoke about. He said, these are the things that's going before you in the last days. So you mean to tell me we're not living in the last days? Nah, but we so consumed about everything else, man. We not watchful. We not prayerful. We so consumed about our jobs. Oh, I gotta get to work on time. You think when Christ said, you gonna be going to work today? Come on, man. It's time to wake up, man. See?
All these are the beginning of sorrow. Then shall deliver you up to be afflicted, and shall kill you, and you shall be hated of all nations for my name's sake.
Yo, you think we're not hated? You think standing out here, we're not hated right now? People want us to pack up and go home, man. But we're not here for that, yo. We're here to tell you, according to the scriptures, it's time to wake up. The Most High is warning you through us. You can't say you never heard it. You can't say you wasn't warned. Come on, man. It's time to get ourselves right, man. It's time to turn off that music, man. It's time to get in tune with the Most High. Turn off that nonsense. If that music ain't helping you, man, it's not helping you get out your condition. If you start keeping the law, statutes, and commandments, I guarantee you, your life will change. It sure changed our life. You got more than that?
Verse 10, and then shall be many offended, and shall betray one another, and shall hate one another, and many false prophecies shall rise. Verse 11, and many false prophets shall rise.
There's many false prophets on this earth, man. Yo, T.D. Jake is one of your biggest false prophets. Joel Osteen is one of your biggest false prophets, man. These guys are not teaching you nothing. They're not teaching you what these prophecies that's going on the earth today. All they want you to do is keep paying your tithes. Keep paying your tithes. Keep coming to church on Sunday and pay your tithes. They're not telling you what's going to happen in a few months. Yo, if we stay in tune with the Most High, you know what's coming. This is what we should be paying attention to, man. The mark of the beast. Why doesn't T.D. Jakes tell you about this? Or Joel Osteen? Why they don't mention this to you? These pastors today is part of the whole scheme of things, man. They want you to keep asleep. They should be warning you for this to come. This is right at our doorsteps, man. We gotta wake up, man. We gotta start preparing ourselves, man. gotta stop preparing, man. Preparation is key, man. Preparation is key. And as a people, we are not prepared. We are not organized, man. We gotta start sitting down and coming together, man. Because that's the only way we gonna survive this. That's the only way we're gonna survive what comes to us, man. And this government wants to destroy our people. They already destroying our people. They got liquor stores in our communities. They got fast food restaurants on every corner. That's destroying our people, man. Our people got the highest level of illnesses. The highest level, man. The same way you fill up the hospitals, the same way you fill up the churches. Tell you, man. That's what we put for entertainment. Singing and dancing. Pure nonsense, man. That's what music is doing to us, man. Yo, music is just another form of indoctrination, man. It's just like going to school and getting an education. It's gonna keep you in a cycle of destruction. That's what hip-hop is doing to our people today, man. There's no guidance. There's no direction. There's nothing in that music, man. But I can tell you where you can find guidance and direction. In the scriptures. In Christ. You're not going to find that anywhere else, man. Tell you, man, we gotta start waking up, man. Yo, you know what? In one angle, I can't wait till these things start coming to pass, so our people will really start waking up, because that's the only time we wake up, when our back is against the wall. When our back is against the wall, that's when we start coming together. That's when we start turning to the Most High. The minute we start experiencing any type of difficulty, that's when we know God. Oh God, please help me. I need a job. I gotta pay my bills. I'm gonna be homeless. That's the only time when we know the Most High, man, through our trouble. Only time we know the Most High, man. We are a rebellious people, man. Ungrateful, man. See?
Isaiah chapter 30, verse 8. Now go, write up before them on the table, and note it in a book, that it may be for the time to come, forever and ever, that this is a rebellious people.
This is a rebellious people. Just look at it. We don't even want to follow the right thing, man. Yo, we got all the right ways to eat right, as far as the dietary laws. We don't even want to keep that. The Bible let us know what we should eat and what we shouldn't eat. That's good for you, man. Forget about all your diet books and all that nonsense, man. Just look into the dietary laws. That's all you gotta do. Look into the dietary laws. Forget about your diet pills and all that nonsense, man. That's our problem, man. We are rebellious. We don't want to follow the Most High, man. You guys are following what our pastor tell us. What the news media tell us to do. What entertainment tell us to do.
This is a rebellious people, lying children, children that will not hear the law of the Lord, which say to the seer, see not, and to the prophet, prophesy not unto us right things.
You want to hear fables, man. You want to hear nonsense. The Bible is telling you what you should and what you shouldn't do. But you'd rather go to some other source that's actually going to be detrimental to you. Yo, we'd rather listen to all these fables and all these nonsense. All these people with high degrees and you know, all these academic qualifications, they can't save your soul, man. They can't help you. Tell me how they're going to help you get out your condition. Tell me one rule they gave you that actually helped your life. First Timothy chapter 4, Sorry, man, we gotta listen to fables, man. Fables are lies, man. You gotta start getting back into the truth, man. Cause that's the only thing that's gonna set us free. 2 Timothy chapter 4 verse 3. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust shall they heap to themselves teachers having itching ears, and they shall turn away their ears from the truth and shall be unto fables. We're going to turn our ears away from the truth, man. Yo, the truth is there's no Christmas in the Bible. That's the truth. If somebody could come up here and show me December 25th in the Bible, yo, we're going to pack up and go home. We're going to pack up and go home. Y'all never see us again. Never. If you could show me Easter, we're not talking about the word Easter, because we know the word Easter was the word Passover originally. So if you can show me the origin of Easter in the Bible, yo, you'll never see us preaching again. Never. Because all these things are fables, man. Tell me the last time you seen a bunny laying eggs. Or Santa Claus coming down the chimney. You ever seen these things? So why are you believing in it?
Yeah, well, are you still there?
Well, that's our people, man. We want to continue in these fables. Like it's going to help us, you know, live a better life. All these holidays is keeping us asleep, man. Every other month is like a new holiday. Just keep putting us back in the same bondage. The next holiday is Memorial Day. Tell me what day, yo, why should you be remembering that day? What's the reason of that day? How have that day sustained your life?
Did that day make you a better person? You got 4th of July, Independence Day. Are you free? Are you free in America? Come on, man. Y'all think y'all free in America? Yo, if you working and paying bills, you're not free, man. You're a slave. You're still a slave, man. You're a slave to the dollar. Matter of fact, you're a slave to sin. Because all these holidays are sinful days, man. These things is of the devil. These things are of the devil, man. Nobody know what the days are the holy days are, what the Most High wants you to follow. He wants you to keep the Passover. He wants you to keep the Feast of Unleavened Bread. He wants you to keep the days of Pentecost. Why your churches are not keeping these days holy? Why didn't I tell you about these days, man? These days are actually in the Bible. The disciples kept these days. How come you're not keeping these days, man? Go ask your pastor. Pastor, what is the day of Pentecost? How come the disciples kept it and why are we not keeping it? Come on, man. It's time to wake up, man. But I want to praise the Most High for giving me the opportunity to talk to my people. There's other brothers up here. I know the Spirit is within us. And I'm going to pass the mic on. Bless you.
Praise the Most High for the brothers. For the brother rightly dividing the word of truth. I thank the Most High for that because we as a people, we've been lied to, we've been dejected, we need truth. There's nothing wrong with truth. But you come to find out that truth, being taught in a wicked society, would not be accepted. I come to find out that anything that's right is not accepted. We would quickly suck into anything that is wrong and accept it as if it's true. We would turn on the TV and follow the lifestyle that's being portrayed through the media. And we will live it as if it is right. Not knowing you're only following someone's imagination. You're only following what somebody thinks you're supposed to be. And you will pick it up so easily. For example, the youth. We will watch the TVs and think it's okay to sell drugs. Because we see our people on the TV selling drugs. And it's like that's the only thing we think is right. We would think, as young men, chasing women is all right. We would think doing the drugs is all right. And everything we follow is through what we've seen on TV. It's through the hip-hop culture, which is a mess. Everything we follow is a bunch of nonsense. And we would not pick up what's right. Do you know what's right? The Bible. The one book which is contrary to the principles that America teaches. Everything that's correct is in the book and it's being ignored. But every Sunday we'll jump around and sing and dance as if we really believe in God. But then when Friday night comes and Saturday night comes, you in the club. Popping bottles. But then you in church on Sunday talking about I love Jesus. You can't be wavering. can't be wavering. You either you follow Christ or you don't. You can't be in between. Another thing, society teaches you to follow the majority. This society teaches you to follow the majority. When Christ said, broad is the way that leadeth to destruction. That should tell you something. If everybody is doing it, then that means it's wrong. If everybody is doing the same thing, that should tell you to move far away from it. That's what Satan is. But not our people. We don't pick up on that. We rather do what's wrong. Here it is. You got a few young brothers up here with bottles in their hands. And now people will walk past. If you see young brothers with Bibles, that should tell you something as well. I'm only 22 years old. What am I doing with a microphone and a Bible? Shouldn't I be chasing some woman somewhere? Shouldn't I be drugged out of my mind? So if we are not doing that, that should tell you something. Maybe there's something you was not told yet, you as an elder. And it's coming out of the mouth of little children, man. That should tell you something. That should tell you to wake up. Maybe something is going on that you don't know about. But you rather ignore it and live your life the way you want to live it. And you think tomorrow is going to be the same way. When you have no idea when the Most High will require your soul. It can be right now, this minute. And you think you're going to live your life the way you want it. But it's not going to happen that way. One day, the Most High is going to visit this land. He's going to visit your iniquity. And that's when you're going to realize you should have changed your life when you had the chance. And that's when it's going to hit you. And a lot of us know that already. But we rather ignore it. But one day, everything is just going to stop. And then judgment. Now what? All the sins you've been doing in your lifetime, you have to pay for it. Believe me. Matter of fact, no, believe the Bible. That's in the Bible. The book that's contrary to America. All your wickedness you're doing on this earth while you are living, you have to pay for it. And that's guaranteed. That's a promise. You think it's a joke.
No.
Well, you can laugh now. But there's a hell. And you're not being warned about it. You would expect to hear the truth from your pastor. All these years you sitting in church. What have you learned? Let me know. All these years in church. You singing and dancing. Paying your tithes. Pastor shaking you down for the money that you can't even pay your rent with. And what have you learned? Christmas. Where is that in the Bible? You've been doing it all your life. There should at least be a scripture in the Bible for Christmas. Where is that? Easter. All your years you've been doing it. Where is that in the Bible?
Hey, Mama.
I thought you were paying your pastor for truth. Give me Isaiah 52. It is time for an awakening. Matter of fact, it's already going on. Read.
Isaiah chapter 52, verse 1. Awake, awake.
Do what?
Awake, awake.
The Most High is trying to shake you awake, man. But you ignoring it. You turn your face the other way instead of inquire about what's being told. or what's being talked about. Read.
Put on thy strength, O Zion. Put on thy beautiful garments, O Jerusalem.
That means remove your old garments and put on your beautiful ones. That means remove your iniquity. Remove your sins and come back to being righteous the way we initially were. Read.
The holy city, for henceforth there shall no more come into thee the uncircumcised and the unclean. Shake thyself from the dust.
The Most High says, shake yourself off the dust, man. We've been trodden down underfoot for way too long. We've been on the bottom for way too long. How can you be so comfortable living on the bottom? How? Read.
Shake thyself from the dust. Arise and sit down, O Jerusalem.
And the Most High is talking to his people. Jerusalem, that's us. We the Jews. Not them people over there, man. The people who are traditionally recognized as a Jew, they are imposters. He's talking to us, the people who are lost, the people who are trodden down on the foot, the people who are on the bottom, suffering. The people who have no one to plead for their cause, that's us. That's who the Most High is talking to. But we don't want to listen. Really?
Lose thyself from the bands of thy neck.
Most I say, remove yourself from your captivity. Break off your bonds. The truth is here. That's our emancipation. The truth. That's our freedom. You think you're free in America. No, you're not. Because you're still in the land of your captivity. We came off of slave ships in this country. And in the West Indies, and in Haiti. How can you feel free in the country that kept you as a slave? If you're in debt, you're a slave. If you're working, you're a slave. If you have to pay bills, you're a slave. Straight. How can you feel comfortable in this country, man? The Most High is trying to shake you loose, but you're ignoring him. He's lending out his hand for you, and you are ignoring him. You gotta follow Satan. Because that's the only person you following here in this country. Nothing in this country is correct. Everything wrong, you can find it here. And we pick it up so easily. Read.
O captive daughter of Zion.
Oh who?
O captive daughter of Zion.
That's us. Read.
For thus said the Lord, ye have sold yourself for naught.
Read again.
For thus said the Lord, ye have sold yourself for naught.
We have sold ourselves for nothing, man. We have sold ourselves for nothing. And this is the reason why we are in this condition. For nothing, man. And we will not think maybe we are better than this. We lost our dignity. We lost our honor. Now we are nothing. Our young men walking with their pants under their behind. Drugged out of their mind. We have become nothing. Our women swinging down poles. We chasing money. That's become your God now, the money. When the Bible says the money is the root of all evil. And that's all we know now, money. What you gonna do when it crash? When it